Hi there, welcome back to another Scriptcase tutorial. This video is going to look at some more ways to export via email in Scriptcase. This is going to look at some custom PDFs if you want to completely customize the look and feel and the data of your PDF. So in the last video, we looked at some built-in ways to do this that Scriptcase provides. So for this, we're going to need a grid. We're going to need a PHP button on that grid. We're going to utilize a TCPDF library, which comes built in the Scriptcase. And we're going to use an SMTP API. This is going to be one of the ones we set up in the last video. And then we're going to use a little bit of PHP code. So this is some code that you might have seen from a previous series that I did with Scriptcase. And so it might look familiar, but it's pretty simple. So as you can see, we have a grid here, and we're going to do an invoice. So these are some line items on an invoice, and we're going to put a button up here to go ahead and send an invoice to the customer so that we can collect payment on these items that they bought. So let's go over to Scriptcase now and get started with doing this. So this is our grid, and we need to add a PHP button first. So let's go to buttons and go to new button here, right here on the left. And then we can go ahead and choose PHP and then go ahead and name it. So I'm going to choose send invoice, like so. That's ready to go, and that's how it'll look on the screen. Click create on that, and there's a little display of what it looks like and a section for some PHP code, which is where we're going to put our code to go ahead and send our invoice. So the first thing we need to do is include the TCPDF library right here. So this is the SC include lib macro. You can find it in the documentation, but all that's doing is including that library into this application. That library comes with Scriptcase, so you don't have to go out and get it on the internet. Then we need to add our API here. So if we go up to Tools API, we're going to do our Gmail one right here. So there's those settings. We set that up in the previous video. You can look at that, but it's pretty simple. And it's just named Gmail. So we're going to use that over here in some more macros that allow us to send an email using that. But first, we need to set up our PDF. So let me go ahead and copy some code in here for you to use, you to see. So the first thing we're doing is we're setting up a TCPDF object here, and we're giving it some settings here. These are just some different settings to make it look a little bit more like an invoice. We're going to add a page. We're setting the font, and then we're setting an initial Y position on that. So that's on an XY coordinate system. It's how everything is set up. So we're setting an X and the Y and some different settings here for layout here. We're putting a title up at the top. This is like our company name, so any carpenter is going to be mine. Setting a new font here and updating our text Y position just so we can keep track of where we are. And then we're putting a header row on here for the item, price, and total. And then we're updating a total value. That's going to allow us to put a total right at the bottom of the screen. And then we're adding an offset value here so that we have an offset to use later on when we start using this data. Next thing we need to do is start accessing our data from the database. So we have an SQL query for this, and this is going to be pretty much the same one. I set this up kind of a custom SQL query, so you can look at this later if you want. All this code will be made available. As you can see, I have a select statement here pulling from our detail sales table, as well as our products table and our sales table as well, so that we've got our sale ID and our product information as well. And we're limiting this to sale ID is 15. That's the sale ID on the grid. We could limit this some other ways, but we're just doing it this way to keep it simple for now. We're selecting that all that data, and then we can go ahead and loop through that data and put it onto our PDF page that we just built. So let's go ahead and copy a little bit more code here. So we're looping through that data. We're saving it in the DS variable, looping through it all until we get to the end. And for each one, as you can see, we're getting that unit price and the quantity out of the query and the name as well here. So product, price, quantity, and then we're going to put them on the screen here. So we're doing some math there to figure out where on the screen it's going to be so it lines up with the headings and is on the same line for everything. And some formatting here for the product name, price, make sure it's formatted as a currency, and then the quantity and the total as well. And then we're calculating that total, the grand total for the invoice, and then updating the offset. So we're bumping it down on the page, then just jumping to the next record there. After that, everything should be on the page, and we can go ahead and close out the PDF here and send the email. So let me copy a little bit more code for that so you can see that here. So as you can see, we're closing out that PDF. The lines there, we're going to add in a total. So that's our grand total. We're going to put it at the bottom and some messaging at the bottom as well. And then we're outputting it here to a folder. I created the invoices folder, and you can name it however you want. You can make sure it's unique, or you can overwrite it here. And the F means it's saving it to a file instead of pushing it to the browser. Then we can go ahead and close the PDF. So now we have a file created here, and we can go ahead and send that file to our customer. So that's our next part. We need to build in the code to send the email. We're going to use that email API profile. Let's go ahead and look at the documentation for how we do that inside of Scriptcase using their macros. So here's the SE send mail API macro, very useful macro. We just need to pass through some settings here. And here's some options for what those settings are here. So we can pass through the profile. That's going to be the name of the profile we created. Some settings for that if we're not passing through the API profile, and then also the message itself here. So as you can see, we're using a profile in this setting, the email body, the text, if it's HTML or not, the to address and the subject as well, and then we're just sending it there. Got some different options here if we were setting it up manually instead of using an API profile, or if we wanted to use Amazon or Mandrill that we talked about in the last video here. For now, we're going to keep it simple, use our profile, so we just need to pass through our message settings here. So let me copy in some more code right down here at the bottom after the PDF has been created and output and saved to the drive. Here's our code. So we have that array that's using that Gmail API. That's what I named that API profile right there, Gmail. And then is our text. We're just going to keep it plain text, no HTML, attached is your invoice. Sending it to my email, anycarpenter@gmail.com. The subject is invoice, and the attachment is going to be that same file path that we created up there. And then we just send it, and it should be ready to go in our inbox when we send it. So here's the grid now, all loaded, and there's a send invoice button, so we can go ahead and click on that. And it's going to go ahead and send our invoice once it does that. So right now, as you can see, there's no messaging here. We just click OK. We could display some messaging there. We'll look at it in a second. But for now, we're going to look at our email. There it is. And it looks like it's from us and everything, which looks good. And there's our invoice. So very basic, just a very simple way to format this. But there's our total, all of our line items. Everything's easy and set up, ready to go. Now, if we wanted, we could control whether or not there's a message there. So right now, there's no message. If we go back here, all we need to do is echo out right at the very end whatever we want, and it's going to display it there. So that might be a little bit more useful to your users. So I'm just going to echo out the email was sent with an exclamation mark there. So they're all ready to go. They know it actually went and it did something. Go ahead and click run on that. And it'll come around in just a second. And this time we'll get that message here. So there it is. Click send invoice again. And this time we'll get that message. It's just a very basic message. You could format that however you wanted. And then click OK. And that message will be in our email address. So that's just a very basic way. If we wanted to move that button around on our toolbar, lots of different settings there. We could go to toolbar. We looked at this some in the last video. But maybe it makes sense to move it over a little bit. For your users to see. So there's that button there. So everything in that menu is what's on the toolbar. So let's move it up here to before the group by. So it's going to be right at the beginning of the center section, right after the left section. So we go ahead and run that, and that should be moved on our screen. It'll look a little bit nicer. And there we go. So there is our send invoice button right there on that left side of the center section. So that's some different ways to send an email, a custom email export from Scriptcase.